The last person say, Mr. But what is the last question? Come on. Hello. What did Teja say? What is the last question? Where are you? Are you listening to me? Where are you now? Respond one of you. Come on.
Give the react. Give the reaction of COH taken twice with Cl2.
That's over, right? And I given this one now. Order of solubilities.
Yes, sir. That one was also done.
Order yes, sir. That is also given.
That is the last question now.
Yes, sir.
Then will you say something other? Come on, explain why. Next question. Explain why. Alkali and alternate metals. Alkali and alternate metals cannot be produced by reduction methods.
Sir, they are only very strong reducing agents.
They are strong reducing agents. We cannot easily reduce these particular alkali and alkaline metallic compounds by using any reducing agent. Generally, we apply electrochemical reduction methods. Right. As these are strong reducing agents, we cannot reduce. Alkali or alkaline electrochemical compounds, alkali or alkaline earth metal compounds by using any reducing agent. Therefore, we cannot produce these metals. These metals by common reduction reactions. These can be produced by. Can be produced by electrochemical reduction methods only. That's this is the decomposition reaction of calcium nitrate. You are decomposing. Come on, predict the products. Yashraj, come on, say what products you get here. What are the products calcium nitrate on decomposing?
Calcium oxide.
Welcome oxide.
Oxygen.
Oxygen.
Then NO2.
NO2. Good. So all the secondary group nitrate decompose like lithium nitrate. Lithium nitrate and magnesium nitrate are diagonal related. Lithium nitrate and magnesium nitrate similarly decompose. Not only magnesium, like lithium nitrate, all the secondary group nitrates also decompose. But beryllium nitrate is different, already given to you. So, to CDO, 4 NO2 plus O2, 2 paramagnetic gases are getting. Next. Why salts are commonly, why lithium salts are commonly hydrated. And those of other alkali metal salts are usually anhydrous, explained. Anhydrous explained. Narayan, come on, say Narayan. Why lithium salts are hydrated but not other alkali metal salts?
Sir, lithium is an exception, sir. It has very small size and then it has more hydration energy.
Heat of hydration, high heat of hydration.
Smaller size, greater charge density. Okay. Smaller size, greater charge energy, it can hold more number of water molecules. That is the reason. Hydration energy is different. You are putting in water, that is liberating more hydrate, more amount of energy, that is hydrate energy. Lithium plus is very small, greater charge density, it can hold more number of water molecules. So much more lithium salts are hydrated. Okay, good. Lithium plus ion is small. Lithium plus ion is small versus greater charge density. Therefore, lithium salts are generally hydrated. But other alkali metal ions, bigger, possess less charge density. Therefore, their salts are anhydrous. Right, in cement, one point I did not give. This is very important point right now. I give you one more important point in cement. Take it. In Portland cement or in alumina cement, one of the important components is dry calcium aluminator. This is CaO Al2O3. This is CaO3 Al2O6. It can be well represented as Ca9 multiplied by 3. Again, actually, it is like this: Al6, O18. In Portland cement or aluminum cement, the important component is calcium aluminate. This is generally like this: we are writing, can be well represented as Ca9, Al6, O18. Remember, Remember, it is, it contains, right? It contains dual membered rings. Of SiO-Si linkages, SiO-Si linkages joined with 6 NO4 minus tetrahedrons. Nitrogen and SiO-Si linkage is forming a dual member rings with the SiO-Si and 6 are there for tetrahedra. It's a very important statement, remember. The least soluble in water among the following. Least soluble in water among the following. This CR4, SR CR4, VS CR4, VS CR4. Shivani, come on, say. This is this side of the Shivani. Shivani, can you answer? Shivani, Papani, come on. Can you answer this? Least soluble. Aditya, come on. Aditya Dayal. Reading or not?
Sir, BACR04.
BACR04, good. Bigger anion, top to the bottom. The bigger anion, soluble depend on interpretation. Least interpretation, least soluble. Very good answer. Right, next. What is the composition of mineral trona? Think about this. Na2CO3 plus Na2CO3 2H2O is composed of what is called trona. Next. Next question. There is a loss in mass. There is a loss in mass. A loss in mass when mixture of lithium carbonate. And sodium carbonate is heated strongly. The weight loss is due to both a Na to CO3 plus Na to CO3 NH2O. Only Na to CO3. Only Na to CO3 NH2O. This mixture you are heating, there is a loss in rate. So due to only hidden carbonate or sodium carbonate or both. Srinika, ready, come on. You can see. Can you go? Bharat ready? Bharat? Huh?
Sir, I think lithium will get the water molecules absorbed and then the mass will decrease, so B option.
Lithium carbonate you are heating. Lithium carbonate you did not add any water to the side. Lithium carbonate.
Both,
lithium
sir.
Carbonate you are heating. Decompose or not?
Yes, sir, it will decompose.
Yes, CO2 it is losing definitely.
CO2.
Right. Next time. Sodium carbonate NH2 you are heating. It is losing water or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
so both, sir.
Yes, sir.
Both. But sodium carbonate after dehydration, even it is not decomposing even on red hot. Sodium carbonate doesn't decompose even on red hot.
Yes, sir.
Up to water it is going on losing. It loses water, it loses CO2, but it is not losing CO2. It never loses CO2, even red hot. It loses CO2, it loses water. Both. Both, right. This is a confusing question. Right, next one. Last of Paris is hardened by. Last of Paris is hardened by. It's multiplied by 2-3 times the terms. Last of Paris hardened by. Give him what? Equal to utilizing water. Change into calcium carbonate. Giving out water.
Utilizing water, sir.
Utilizing water.
Sir, utilizing water if we give up.
Utilizing water. Water. Sir, what I said now. Utilizing water. So hardened by utilizing water, it expands, it converts into calcium sulfate, gypsum. I given it clearly, very, very important. Next. Next. What is Kinase cement? It is a mixture of alum. Plus gypsum, not gypsum, plaster of Paris. Mixture of alum plus plaster of Paris. Once you are putting water and allow it to set, it shall be hard mass. This mixture is known as Kinase cement. Last question, right hand close. Why is sodium bicarbonate insoluble? But potassium bicarbonate is soluble. bicarbonate is soluble. Chintu Chandrahas, come on. Mr. Chintu, come on. Sodium bicarbonate is insoluble, potassium bicarbonate is soluble. Chintu, come on. Mr. Chintu. Anthony, Mr. Anthony. Anthony, Perio, Hamsini, Hamsini, Mangalapalli, come on. Hamsini, Perio. Insoluble, soluble, right? Anybody, come on.
Sir. Bicarbonate ion is bigger, sir. So the solubility depends on heat of hydration.
Depends on lattice energy.
Sodium bicarbonate is a polymer because of hydrogen bonding between bicarbonate molecule, bicarbonate anion. It is actually sodium bicarbonate inside the polymer. Any polymer is insoluble. But potassium bicarbonate, because of bigger size, it cannot fit into intermolecular space which are bonded by hydrogen bond. Therefore, potassium is hardly insoluble in dimer. But rubidium, cesium bicarbonates are monomers. So, capital water solubility increasing. Sodium bicarbonate is insoluble only due to polymeric nature. That's all. Sodium bicarbonate is insoluble due to polymeric nature. Polymeric nature. But potassium bicarbonate is soluble because it is dimer. Because it is dimer. Let me come to the regular class. Let us close it today. Come on. Where is topic? Alums, no?
Uses of alum, sir.
Alums also completed. Right? 1.8. Note right. Note about pseudo alums. What are pseudo alums? Not pseudo alums. Whenever there is divalent and trivalent double sulfates, double sulfates of monovalent and trivalent alum, and double sulfates of divalent and trivalent, that is known as what? Pseudo alum. Means what? Now you take the four, XSO4, trivalent, and Y2, SO4, taken thrice, 24, H2. For example, it is ferrosulfate, suppose. Ferrosulfate and aluminum sulfate. Ferrosulfate, aluminum sulfate. Like this. You take any, this divalent. Instead of monovalent, once X is a divalent, that will be what it is, pseudoalum. And pseudoalums are not isomorphous. Pseudoalum and alum structures are not identical. That also a point. Come on. Divalent and trivalent. Double sulfates are known as pseudoalums. Pseudoalums. Next, pseudoalums are not isomorphous. Morphous means structure. Not isomorphous with alums. Example. Sodium peroxyborate, last year I put it on this, sodium peroxyborate. Already given one preparation method, sodium peroxyborate. Na2, O2, O2 taken twice, O2, 2H2O, 2H2O. Or this can also be written Na2, B2, O2 taken twice, OH taken 4. Don't confuse both are same. Preparation. Just in a question, therefore I'm testing this particular preparation. Preparation. Already one preparation method already given to you. Boric acid with sodium hydroperoxide. One. Electrolysis of sodium borate. Sodium borate in presence of sodium carbonate. Sodium borate and sodium carbonate. Make sure you are electrolyzing. Then you're reading. Na3, BO3, plus Na2, BO3. Electrolysis, not a biological equation. Electrolysis product I'm writing. This is simply Na2, B2, O2 taken twice, OH taken 4. This is the question I made last year, image. Therefore, I'm giving this one. One of the preparation method of sodium peroxyborate. Sodium borate and sodium borate mixture you are electrolyzing, you'll be getting this one. Not the biological equation. I did not write the biological equation. Boric acid, this is already made in the notes. And the boric acid reaction I give this one. Boric acid with the sodium hydroperoxide. Sodium hydroperoxide. NaOH. Even I give this reaction made in the notes. 2H3. CO3 plus 2NaOH. NaOH. We have Na2, B2, O2 twice, OH taken 4 plus 2H2O. Third, so this is the reaction appear in one of the IIT advanced exam last year and before last year. Now, sodium metabolite. Sodium metabolite. That is NaPO2. NaPO2 with the hydrogen peroxide. NaPO2 plus H2O2. Then Na2, B2, O2 twice, OH4. Single addition product. Single product, no other thing. Single addition product. So remember, it's already given, sodium peroxyborate can be written in different ways. Once again, I am writing that. Sodium peroxyborate can be written as sodium peroxyborate can be written as. Right, already given the notes. Second time I am writing. O2 twice, O2, 2H2O, Na2, B2, O2 twice, OH, taken 4. Then into O2 twice OH taken 4 minus 2 or V2OA minus 6, removing H plus 7, 6. This I said dehydration. You are dehydrating. Na2V2O6. 2H2O I removed. So that 6. This is molecular formula I take. Molecular formula. This, you can write like this. NaVO3. Empirical formula. Molecular empirical. It's very basically equivalent to peroxybutyrate. Structure also I divide by O clearly illuminate once again. This one, structure of B2, O2 taken twice. OH taken 4 minus 2. Are you taking knots? Two peroxy bonds, four peroxy oxygens. Right.
Yes, sir.
Right. Use this of 20-peroxyburate. Use this, remember, this one, 20-peroxyburate uses. This energy utilized, energy utilized brightener in washing powders. Nowadays you are also getting the washing powder with a brightener. So the brightener in this particular. So this particular sodium peroxyborate utilized brightener in washing powders. One. Next, it is compatible with the enzymes. Easily do a friendship with enzymes in our body. It is compatible. Easily combines, easily works along with the enzymes. It is compatible with enzymes. Therefore, it is mainly used along with the biological powders. Next. This particular aqueous solution I am heating to 80 degrees centigrade. Aqueous solution of this are heating to 80 degrees centigrade. This hydrogen, this peroxy bonds are breaking, producing hydrogen peroxide. Therefore, it also acts as good oxidizing agent. Right? Sodium peroxyborate used as brightener in washing products. Next. It is compatible with enzymes. Compatible. Friendly. Compatible. Bio-friendly like that. Compatible with enzymes. Therefore, use them. Biological products. A tonics and enzyme mixture will be added. Next, the aqueous solution are leading to above 80 degrees centigrade. Above 80 degrees centigrade. 80 degree centigrade. The peroxy bonds break. The peroxy bonds break. Produce hydrogen peroxide. Produce hydrogen peroxide. Therefore, it can be used as an oxidizing agent. Used as good oxidizing agent. Good oxidizing agent. Right, next, aluminium. 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 Minerals. You know, fixation of aluminium in the very important Hall Seraud process. Every year, a question in the Hall Seraud process. Very important. Minerals. Four and down. End of the four and down. Diaspore. Diaspore. Bauxite. Bauxite. Gibbsite. All right, what are you deciding to define? Gibbsite. Cryolite. 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 Alunite. Irresophore. Decadrize. Three air wise taken rice. Alunite. Alunite. Potassium feldspar. Kale SIP weight. Blue. Sapphire. Sapphire. Blue and old.
Yes, sir.
Right. Steps in the extraction of aluminium. Steps in the extraction. Actually, right, from bauxite, right? Only from bauxite. From bauxite. Transfer over of aluminium bauxite from bauxite. Steps in extraction. Concentration of the ore. Concentration of the ore. chemical reduction of alumina. Chemical reduction of alumina. Alumina. Refining of aluminium. Refining of aluminium. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Take the first step. Concentration of the wall. So before concentration of the wall in thoroughly powder. Wall in the bauxite or in thoroughly powder and roasted. Wet bath, roasted. To convert any amount of in the bauxite there will be the amount of actually iron impurity something. Iron impurity Fe2O3 or FeO. There should not be any FeO. It interrupts the extraction. Therefore, the ore is thoroughly before going to concentrate the ore is thoroughly powdered and roasted in order to convert any amount of FeO to Fe2O3. Right, the point. Before going to concentration of bauxite ore, before going to concentration of bauxite ore, the ore is powder the ore is powder roasted in order to convert any amount of FeO to Fe2O3 FeO to Fe2O3. Bauxite. See, bauxite is available in two forms. One is red bauxite, second one is white bauxite. Red bauxite, white bauxite, right as it is. So, whatever I am writing on the board, take down. Like this only, make it. Available in two forms. One is red bauxite, second one is white bauxite, right on. White bauxite. Come on. Carry impurities. Impurities, especially very impurities of iron impurity. Very impurity. The other way there is silica and all very minor, but main impurity is applicable. Here. Carry impurity. Silica, main impurity is silica. Whether other main is main is silica. Now, purified by, what is purified now? Purified by A, two methods. A, valence process. Valence process. The reagent what we use? The reagent. point state. Sodium hydroxide. Second, Hulse process. Two methods we apply, Hulse process. Here, the reagent is sodium carbonate, that's all. Only that is different. Sodium hydroxide, sodium carbonate. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Completed.
Completed, sir.
Right, carry impurity, SiO2, purified by Celtex process. Celtex process. Remember all the process in which is actually prepared. Generally, after they are given the matching knowledge, very general. Don't miss any point. If you are missing a point, that we are putting somewhere, right? Celtex process. Reagents. Coke plus N2. N2 gas plus coke. These are the reagents you apply. Bayer's process, come on. Aluminum oxide every year question. Some typical point they are giving and asking you and confusing you. Be very careful about this aluminum extraction, right? Bayer's process. Bayer's process. Chit about one line for a while. First, we'll look carefully after writing all the reactions and all. And write down and dictate the notes and all. Chit about. Don't try for a while. Look here. A2O3, this is about what I said, ferric oxide impurity. This is the ore, this is the gangue impurity, you are right. Then we are treating with the sodium hydroxide. Who is sodium hydroxide? Sodium is added, heated to high temperature. Look here. So we are adding NaOH. Then fuser. So really 150 degrees anyway, either they are heating. Then this is amphoterate, this is basic. So this is salivary, this one. Repeat both they also amphoterate only, don't say. But repeat both they have a little more basic character than A2O3. More basic character. Therefore, repeat both three basically it is amphoterate. But in comparison to A2O3, repeat both little basic. Therefore, Fe2O3 is not salivary sodium hydroxide. Our aim is to separate Fe2O3. Fe2O3 is a little more basic. It is not salivary sodium hydroxide. Fe2O3 is amphoterate. Salivary sodium hydroxide. So that, look here. 2 NaAO2 plus 2 NaAO2 plus chloramine base H2O. Sodium metalaminate. Sodium metalaminate. This sodium metalaminate last year, by two chemicals already given to you in sodium hydroxide reaction already given. This NaAO2 plus 2H2O, this can be written like this. Generally, confusion arises, don't confuse. This can be written like this. author says sodium metaluminate can be written like this. Instead of giving like this, they will give like this and conclusion. Don't confirm. This is the last question of the exam. Next. After getting sodium metaluminate with highly soluble, the complex form soluble. So that, see the board. Don't write any CaO2 dissolved in excess of water. So that you are getting aluminium hydroxide. What is the color? White gelatinous precipitate. It has come at least 3-4 times till now. Okay? So it is white gelatinous precipitate. Followed by you are getting back your NaOH. Yes, NaOH. This is insoluble, no? Filter and separate aluminum hydroxide. After getting separation of aluminum hydroxide, take into open air or sunlight, dry for some time. After that, then take the same aerial OH taken rice, ignited. After drying the little, ignited, heat more than around 1000 degrees centigrade, ignited. Then, including minus 3H2O, you are getting back Al2O3. What is the rain? You have to get Al2O3, you have to separate this one. This is actually compound, but it has a little more basic character. Therefore, this is not soluble in sodium hydroxide, but Al2O3 is soluble in sodium hydroxide. So that we are separating Al2O3 from Fe2O3. That is the Bayes process. Very important. Come on. Right, first one. Red bauxite carry, first point, red bauxite carry Fe2O3 as impurity. Fe2O3 as impurity. Impurity. This red bauxite treated with, this red bauxite treated with sodium hydroxide, remember, reagent in base versus sodium hydroxide. It is sodium hydroxide. As Al2O3 is compatible, as Al2O3 is compatible, soluble in sodium hydroxide. Soluble in sodium hydroxide. Produce a highly soluble sodium metaluminate. Highly soluble sodium meta-aluminate. Aluminate, soluble. Soluble. Next slide. Fe2O3, which is basic, not soluble in sodium hydroxide. Not soluble in sodium hydroxide, can be separated. Right. First reaction, right? This also mentioned. Sodium metaluminate can be written like this. Both. This and this. Completed. Completed.
Yes, sir.
Right. Next, the sodium metaluminate dissolved in excess water, aluminum hydroxide gets precipitated. It is separated it is separated by filtration dried, ignited to get Al2O3. These two, next two.
Yes, sir.
Next, pulse process, you know what? Pulse. Pulse process. If only the difference is sodium carbonate. Mr. Bayer has used sodium hydroxide, but the same laboratory, other scientists has used the sodium carbonate. That is only difference. So, look the word. Now, which are the sodium hydroxide, now sodium carbonate. To any NO2, here no water. No water. It is getting water, CO2. Then, after it is sodium metabolic rate, we are diluting with water, and we are passing CO2 now. That is only the difference. To the board, don't try. We are passing CO2. Then we are getting again, take 2, then a roto, then here, 2 ANOH taken rise. We are passing CO2 now. The previous case you got NaOH. This case you are passing CO2. Then you are getting sodium carbonate. Yes, you got around sodium carbonate. Well, and it is soluble in water, in insoluble precipitate, separated by filtration, dry, ignited, to get Al2O. The previous case NaOH. Here, NaOH. That is only the difference. That's all. Right? The red bauxite is treated with sodium carbonate as Al2O is amphoterate soluble in sodium carbonate. Sodium carbonate, but ethyl body not soluble in sodium carbonate. That can be separated by filtration. Why filtration? Right, first equation.
Yes, sir.
Right. Next. sodium metallic grade. Sodium metallic grade. Diluted by water, and followed by CO2 is passive. CO2 is passive. CO2 is passive. Aluminum hydroxide gets precipitated. Aluminum hydroxide gets precipitated. Precipitated. The sodium carbonate is regenerated. Sodium carbonate is regenerated. Regenerated. The aluminum hydroxide separated by filtration, separated by filtration, dry, dry, ignited, dry, ignited. Put that air to it. Air to it. Right, this one. One is Bayer, this is what the Hulls. The difference is sodium carbonate. In the next class, till something the extraction part we complete next class. Okay.